Hello, Initiate. Recently, Abstergo Historical Research began several new projects in London. We both know that when Abstergo makes big moves, the Templars are up to something. We think they're hot on the trail of a new piece of Eden. I've got people in London looking for it.
Hey, Bishop! Jacob and Evie Fry are twins. How awesome is that?
Speak of the devil. Fire up your cameras, Bex.
I've got picture. ETA on the payload.
Sending it now.
A lot to sift through. I'm gonna get the initiates on it ASAP.
You look weird with a weapon. Let's plant a little bug and see what we can see. Got something. Isabel Ardant has a meeting here in a few hours. Doesn't say with who.
Doesn't say with whom, Rebecca. I suppose it's down to Muggins here to find out.
Hold on. The mission was to find data to locate a piece of Eden in London.
We did.
And now I am eager to try this new kit.
I don't like it when those two go off book like this. Well, all we can do is take a deep breath and move forward. You'll be searching for the Peace of Eden through the lives of Jacob and Evie Fry, twin assassins who operated in Victorian London. Your first set of genetic memories are downloaded. Good luck.
Brother George, it is as I feared. London has fallen. Thrice I have written to you begging your aid. Thrice you've responded with silence. And yet I write again. So desperate my need, so few my options. I need you. London needs you. You would say it is too great of a task, or that it is not yet time to strike. Patience, you would counsel. But whilst you wait, the Templars consolidate their power. They have chosen a Grand Master so ruthless, so thorough, one might think Reginald Birch himself had returned. His name is Crawford Starrick, and he intends to rule the world. There is no aspect of society he does not control, no industry that escapes his grim touch. By day, it is corrupt merchants and venal politicians who hold court. Come night, a vicious street gang known as the Blighters strikes terror in the hearts of all. There is no business untainted by his poison, no person unexploited, be it by duplicity or force. Our enemy has designs on the highest office of them all. And so, as you look inward, and dare I say it, afraid, Crawford Starrick's ambition is fixed on the beyond, to kingdoms and continents as yet unconquered, though not for long, for he knows. As I have warned you time and time again, whosoever controls London controls the world.
The iron ship's from here. The Templar running things is Rupert Ferris and our target one. Target two is Sir David Brewster, who's got his hands on a bauble that could ruin us in this wretched war. Think you both can handle it?
What a question.
All right. My mistake. Ladies and gentlemen, the unstoppable Fry twins. See them nightly at Covent Garden.
George, honestly, I've studied the plans of the laboratory and have every route covered.
And I've got all I need right here. I'll extend your regards to Ferris.
Chat later, George. We have a train to catch.
Jacob! Evie! May the Creed guide you, you vagrants!
Poor man. More afraid than ever. Years have not been kind.
Evie Fry, where do you get it from?
The same place as you, Jacob.
Have fun.
Don't die.
Like this. It's disrupting the other workers. Shut his traps and get the machine fixed. And send me some laudanum for my head.
Coming right up. Locked.
What do you think you're doing?
Stop now! Before there's trouble!
No one goes in or out, unless there's a problem.
I halt the machines. That door opens, and I have my route to Ferris. Sanitary inspector. This man is dead.
You're the dead man!
Run along home. I will teach you how to beg for mercy.
Me.
Will you continue?
Time to head for higher ground.
Do you not think that anyone currently in prison would give their right arm to have jobs such as yours? Well, Mr. Ferris has mandated that those who work in the factory over extern will receive double rations.
say that again. The boys had to carry you back to the yard.
Whatever shall I do?
Still see you, pal.
What's wrong with this city?
Mr. Ferris, sir, the lad in the factory should be taken to be bandaged by the apothecary.
Fine, but dock his wages.
Yes, sir.
Shall we arrive at a final price, Mr. Ferris?
Of iron ore that will continue to generate a steady profit for many a year to come and provide the raw material to build several new trains.
It is done.
Oh? What did you accomplish, boy? A vault loosened in Starek's machine. A large bolt, but not enough.
Your Grandmaster will fall.
You assassins can circle London to your heart's content. The mechanism we have built has been going strong for 100 years and will run 1,000 more. It is the very city itself.
We will take London from your hands.
From Croydon? You lurk in the shadows like a coward. I doubt it.
We seem to have made an unscheduled stop.
Next time I'll walk.